Sad. I know it's terrible, but please try and be brave.
Zell, you know, since all this happened, it is now that Angela has found out. Where was she all this time? Her children are dead, and no one could find her to tell her.
Pete, I spoke to Cleo, and she told me that Angela was seen with Sandra at a disco the same night the children died.
What are you saying, Harry? That whilst her babies are lying in the morgue, she was out dancing?
I understand they got so drunk that the security guard had to call a taxi cab for them. They were actually sitting in the parking lot on the ground. Can you believe that, Peter?
What has come over Angela? Why is she behaving so badly?
Peter, have you considered that there might be something bothering her? It's not normal for a mother to behave like that.
Sweetheart, you don't know Angela.
I guess I don't. Anyway, Peter, I don't feel comfortable going to the house. I'd rather stay at the guest house if you don't mind. Harry will take care of me if you're busy at home.
If that's what you want, baby, it's okay with me. Harry, is that okay with you?
Sure, Pete. That'll be fine. Also, Cleo is coming over this weekend for the funeral. She'll have some company.
Hurry up, guys. I have to get back to the house.
Hands that are strong, but wrinkled, doing work that never stops. Hear this lost time. Of the beauty by too many hours in the sun, eyes that show some disappointment, and there's been quite a lot in her life. She's the foundation I my woman, my woman, my wife.
Would you like some company?
If you have come to tell me off, then I don't.
I've come to say I'm very sorry that you've lost your children. I know how you're feeling, as I'm feeling the same way too.
Peter, I'm sorry I wasn't here. I just wanted a bit as things were going on so badly here. I didn't even see them before they died.
It's okay, Angela. It's okay. Don't blame yourself for what has happened. It is not your fault. Hey, it could happen to anyone. As Mom will always say, it is God's will.
Two little babies were born in the spring.
Peter, don't let this girl hurt you again.
I lost control of my mind and my soul, but my woman's faith carried us. When she reaches that river, every day has been uphill. We climb, but we can't reach the top. I'm weak and I'm easily discouraged.
It's okay.
She just smiles.
Hello, Harry. How are you doing?
I'm not too good, Pete. Are you alone?
Not really. Why?
Please call me back when you're alone.
Okay. Hey, it's getting chilly out here. Won't you go inside?
Is something wrong, Peter?
Not really. Harry just called me. He sounded very concerned.
When she reaches that river, Lord, you know what she's worth. Give her that mansion up yonder, 'cause she's been.
Harry, what the hell is this? Have you guys gone crazy? How can you say something like that?
Pete, I can understand how you feel, but the law is the law and we can't change that. I can only tell you that I promise to handle the case myself.
Harry, I feel as if I'm going crazy.
It's okay, Pete. I'll be there within an hour.
Joe, for God's sake, won't you pull yourself together? There's not much more you can do now but to wait until the police finds out who is responsible for this. Please, let's endure our grief with some dignity. What's the matter, Pete?
I bet it's that damn Angela again. I saw them sitting outside a while ago.
No, it's not her. Harry just told me that.
Told you what?
That they are coming to arrest Badu and Joyce on suspicion of murder.
Joe? Joe, how? And Joyce, what did she do? What did they both do?
I will be here in half an hour.
Don't worry, folks. I'm innocent. And I'll defend my innocence. Please inform Annie and let him make the necessary arrangements.
I don't care what they say.
It's alright, Pete. Don't break my ribs.
Okay.
Miss Martha. Ma'am, do you like it? I just want to cheer everyone up. The house is so sad.
Yes, Joyce, it's beautiful.
Thank you.
But come here a minute.
No, 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 I can't go to jail. I didn't do anything. I didn't kill them. I only made sandwiches. That's all I did. I can't do that. I love them.
It's all right. I know it's a big mistake. But we'll soon find out who the culprit is. Just try and tell them the truth at the police station.
But I didn't do anything.
Definitely. I have to call my dad as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll be fine. So, I'll be fine. You tell him we are coming.
Okay. Dad, I think you better get yourselves ready. I'm on my way to pick up Pajo.
What the hell are you talking about, Harry? Pick him up for what?
I'm afraid he's the number one suspect at the moment, Dad. And it's the law. No one is above it.
The law is an ass. A big one too. Joe is the most innocent person I know. The man can't even kill a fly.
Dad, we are only going to take a statement from him. He'll be all right. I'll be there.
Don't worry, Pajo. I will be right behind you.
Peter, I'll take care of them. He'll be all right.
So you killed my children, you bastard! You can't have any. You are either stealing people's children or murdering them. Murderer! I hope they put you away for good. I hope they hang you.
Face them. It's bad enough facing the executive staff.
I'll do that, Mr. Williamson. Don't worry. Your meeting for today is ready. They are in the boardroom.
Okay, Betty. Let's get it over with.
Hello. Joe, where are you? Are you all right?
Take it easy, Martha. We're coming home.
Oh, thank God. Please hurry home, Joe. Please. Now I can have that cup of tea. I haven't eaten since yesterday.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'll be very brief. You are all aware I have lost my sons under very mysterious circumstances. No one knows what happened. However, for some strange reasons, they have picked up Mr. Evans and they cook in my house.
What have they done?
Well, the police said since Mr. Evans is the last person who gave them food, and Joyce, my cook, is the one who prepared the food.
It's logical, okay, but not necessarily the truth.
Why, Duncan? It makes sense to me. We never know what's on people's mind. You will be surprised to know what people can do.
Oh, come on, Robert. Nobody is talking about that now. We're talking about what's on the ground now, okay? It's impossible for Mr. Evans to kill his own grandchildren. What motive would he have?
Robin, if you don't shut your mouth, I will personally walk over there and shut it for you. You can't talk to me like that. I can damn well do. I own this company, and I'm sick and tired of your stupid innuendos.
Look here, Robin. Shut up if you don't have anything sensible to say. Give me just one reason why Mr. Evans would want to kill his own grandchildren.
Robin, how could you say that? Not Mr. Evans, surely.
Why is it that whenever something negative comes up about Joe Evans, everybody is on the defense for him? Why? Is he God? Can't he do something wrong?
It's okay, Peter. Just take it easy. I mean, you know Robin.
Yes, I know, Robin. That is why I'm so angry.
Anyway, I'm sorry, people. Let's continue with this briefing.
Shall I get you some coffee, Mr. Williamson?
No, better. The funeral of the kids will be on Saturday with refreshment at Terrace Villa. I'll be away for a few days. I hope you can all cope.
Sure, we'll be fine.
And now, Robin, I'll be away for the rest of the week. On Monday morning, I want your resignation letter on my desk. Betty, ask Tim to work out his gratuities. And you, Duncan, find out our legal obligations. Betty, I want all this information on my desk on Monday morning. Do you hear?
Yes, Mr. Williams.
Good. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you know where to find me if I am needed.